I am so excited for this clay dessert tutorial. I can barely stand it.
I'll be using my 3-ingredient homemade clay recipe I shared, but I've taught this with regular kiln-fired clay, and you can also use Sculpey or any modeling clay you might have at home. I'm gonna teach you how to make a cupcake and a piece of pie and how to paint them to make them look so real you're gonna trick someone. If you're new to my channel, hey there, don't forget to subscribe. I upload weekly, or if I'm stuck at home on spring break during a quarantine, I might just load videos every single day. If you've been on my channel for a while or you're one of my students, you know I'm obsessed with drawing food. It all started with artist Wayne Thiebaud. When I was in high school, I was obsessed with his paintings of food. I thought they were so beautiful, so vibrant, and food is something I've always loved. In fact, when I was in high school, my AP portfolio was all about food. I've also found artist Sarah Zinn to be so inspiring. She had a blog and then she made a cookbook with her food illustrations called The Starving Artist. You have to check it out. It's just simply amazing. I love this topic because it's universal. All humans have some sort of relationship with food. And I love how these two artists incorporate that relationship in their work. We're gonna start with the easiest technique of all, and that is making a cupcake. And when I say easy, I mean anyone can make an awesome cupcake. The first step is the marshmallow step. And you're gonna take your hands and roll a ball of clay on the table to create a marshmallow round cylindrical shape. If you're doing this with kiln fire clay, you could make a pinch pot, or you could do the same thing and just hollow it out so it won't explode in the kiln. Next, you roll a nice long coil, and this homemade clay is a little bit crumbly, so I had good luck with this coil. It rolled pretty easy the first time, but don't be frustrated if you have to make a couple because they crack. Then you're gonna make the poop emoji. Just kidding, it's cream cheese frosting. And you just set that bad boy on top of your marshmallow. A little bit of water is all you need to attach these two pieces together. I put water where the two pieces touch and around my corners, and this clay I'm using is not like kiln-fired clay. If I were doing this with kiln-fired clay, I would definitely score slip and blend. Not necessary with this homemade clay. This clay is not great for carving, but I'm taking the end of my knife and I'm pressing in so it looks like my cupcake had a wrapper around it for a little bit of texture. See what I mean? You're done. So easy. I'm now going to show you how to make a slice of pie. And this is also so easy, but I am going to up my detail a little bit to take this to the next level. It's still an easy tutorial, but this is maybe a little bit more intermediate, but seriously, anyone could do it. Start by using your hands to shape a triangular piece of pie that's the size and shape that you would like it. You can also use the tabletop to form it into that perfect triangular shape. Then you're gonna pinch a crust, and you could stop here, but why stop when you can be extra? I'm going to create a lattice crust, which doesn't have to look perfect because keep in mind, desserts are homemade. So I don't want you to be intimidated to try all these extra details because nothing is perfect when it comes to food. And I start by flattening a piece of clay, then I'm gonna cut each strip that will match the shape of my pie. I'm not gonna do any crossing or braiding yet. I'm just gonna measure things out, and then once I'm happy with it, I'll go back and attach them. Just like with the braid, I'm starting with 3, and I'm adding water to where they touch the pie so that it can stick. My first piece across, I'm going over, under, over. And then so my next one is going to be under, over, under. And you just repeat the pattern until it looks right. Remember, it doesn't have to be perfect, but I'm sure there's some perfectionist, excuse me, out there who's gonna put my pie slice to shame. If you're working with Sculpey or air dry clay, you don't have to worry about score slip and blending. But if you're doing this with traditional clay, every time the clay surfaces touch each other, you do need to score slip and blend. I'm taking my paintbrush with water on it and I'm just smoothing the edges so that they're truly attached and not just sat on there. A little more detail in my crust, and I'm feeling pretty happy with this. This is cherry pie, and I want a distinct filling to show on the edges. If you're doing key lime or pumpkin, you might just have a smooth filling, but for any stuffed pie that has round shapes like cherry, strawberry, blueberry,
That's going to be important to carve. So with my tool, I'm just making an indention so I can distinguish what the crust is and where the filling is going to be. And I just smooth out those lines with my paintbrush. I'm drawing in my cherry shapes with the edge of my paintbrush, and then I'm going in to make them a little bit deeper. Again, all of my clay tools are at school, and I'm in quarantine and can't go there, so I'm using just things I can find. And the paintbrush does a great job of smoothing out those lines, and it gives the illusion of form, like there's cherries just spilling out. Speaking of cherries, this piece of pie would not be complete without a nice round cherry on top. Part two of this tutorial is using acrylic paint to paint your air dry clay to make your food look so realistic you could trick someone into eating it. We're going to start with the cupcake, and I'm going to show you very basic color mixing techniques. Here is a cupcake vanilla color, which I'll show you how to make later, but I decided I would like the challenge of mixing a brown using my primary colors, so red, yellow, and blue. You're gonna mix them all together until it's the color that you would like, and always test it out on your surface to see what it looks like on the actual shape. I felt like it was a little too green, so I went back and added a little bit more blue, a little bit more red to give it more of that like chocolate violet effect. And of course, yellow is necessary too to balance out the color so it's not just purple. Once you're happy with your color, and you could have a strawberry cupcake, vanilla, I think red velvet would be amazing, you're gonna paint the base of your cupcake carefully a solid color of your choice. Be careful to go underneath the icing and to not get in there. And then I'm mixing a little bit of white, and I'm putting stripes down my cupcake just like I carved it, so it looks like there's an indention where there was a wrapper around the cupcake. You could always skip this step, but I think it's really easy and it makes it look that much more dimensional. I chose white icing for the challenge of creating shadows, and yes, you're gonna paint the whole top of your icing even if you choose white as your color. I'm gonna mix that chocolate color that I made with a little bit more blue to give it shadows down where the coils overlap. So watch me do it. There's not a huge difference, but I think it's important if you want to take your painting skills to the next level. Although there is a shadow there because it's a three-dimensional form, amping it up with a painted shadow is just going to make it look that much more skilled. Your icing can be any color that you would like, and you would just add a little bit of a darker version of whatever color your icing is to give it that shadowed effect. I'm going to let it dry before I add sprinkles. It's been about 20 minutes and I can't wait any longer to paint my sprinkles. The good news is that it's as easy as it sounds. Mix whatever color you would like, the options are endless, and you're gonna paint whatever shapes you want your sprinkles to be. I wanted to take things up a notch. When you make your cupcake, you could carve it to look like there's a bite mark. You could make it look like there's a wrapper coming off of it, or you could keep things simple and just follow this tutorial exactly. My finishing touches, and then this cupcake is finished. Seriously, this is so easy. You can do it with any type of clay that you have available, and it's just a really fun way to express yourself using food as your subject. Moving on to the pie, I'm gonna up my painting technique, and I'm gonna be mixing more colors. So before I showed you the cupcake color, and I'm gonna be using the same color for my pie crust. Mix a little bit of each primary color, focusing more on the yellow-red range of things. You don't want it to just be orange, so if you just leave it yellow and red, that's what will happen, but a little bit of blue is gonna give it a food crust color, and you do wanna add white as soon as you feel like you're happy with it, and test it out on your surface. Once you're happy with your crust color, go ahead and paint the whole top of your pie. And you wanna be careful moving around your cherry, painting the whole thing, getting in the cracks and crevices of your lattice. I'm picking up my pie so I can get under my cherry. My cherry needs to be bright and gorgeous with red, and so the crust is important, but I wanna be very careful for any fun item that you are gonna add on top. You just wanna make sure your colors stay pure. You're gonna also paint the sides of your crust, and you're gonna find anywhere that there's crust using the same color. Now, I added a little bit more white because I want my crust lattice to look so three-dimensional. So I add a little bit more white and put it on top. So the crisscross is really, really evident. I'm gonna do the same thing with my pie crust itself. I'm gonna use that same brown. I do have to mix up a little bit more of it. And then I'm gonna put a highlight on the top once everything's done. You're gonna paint the sides, you're gonna paint the back, you're even gonna paint the bottom just in case someone picks it up. You want your art to be completely finished. And that's gonna be using that same tan color, adjusting it with white as needed. If you're doing this at home, work to your comfort level. If you already have brown paint or tan paint, you don't have to mix it, but I do think it's a nice bonus because painting your food to represent not just the shape of it, but the colors of it is a really important step, which is why I want this cherry red and eye-catching. I'm just using red straight from the tube, and I'm gonna paint my cherry one solid color. Now, the hard part is finding a small brush that you can kind of dab in the lattice work a little bit, and I almost wonder if I should have done this first and then gone back to put the pie crust on top. But I make it work, and I'm gonna paint my cherry solid red. Now, if you're a beginner with painting, this is fine, you could stop here. But if you've been painting a while or you wanna up your painting, you start with the local color, which means the color the object actually is. Then I mixed a purple. So I took that same red and that same blue and I darkened it, and I'm gonna paint in the crevices or the recessed areas to make it look like it has a shadow. This is key if you want your cherries to look three-dimensional. If you ever look at a piece of pie, once it's in the oven, there's some dark areas. So I'm gonna go back in my lattice and in the shadow of my cherry to make it look super dynamic, like it's been bubbling in the oven. Highlights are so important to create depth. With white, I add a highlight to my cherry, and I kind of blend it into the wet red paint so it has a little bit of dimension to it. And I'm gonna add that white bling highlight again. You'll see me do this a lot. If you're gonna pick one thing to do, shadows or highlights, I recommend just doing the highlights. And I'm gonna take a dry brush and smush it together so it's not just white, but it has a nice fade or blend to it. Then I'll go back and I'll add with a clean brush, a different brush, that white bling highlight that food has because it's so shiny. Think how shiny the cherries inside your pie would be. And you go back and you add that highlight on each and every one and the cherry on top. Now that you've seen me do it once, I'm gonna speed things up and paint the other side. Starting with red, mixing my purple for my recessed areas and my shadows, and then finally adding that nice white highlight to give my cherry just an oozing dimension of color. All done. Two different food tutorials, one so easy, one a little bit harder, but still manageable, to create two food sculptures that look so real and that you can use to express yourself. Before our students start, I always ask them to think, what food memories do they have and what food can they think of that has an importance to them, either as a memory, maybe something that's culturally important, maybe food that you have at a certain holiday or has religious significance. And I am always delighted at the amazing sculptures that students come up with. I'm obsessed with the sushi set that my student made. He even made chopsticks. The ice cream melting on the blueberry pie I thought was so cool. And one of my favorites ever were these deviled eggs that my student made. Her grandmother taught her how to make them, and she made them for every holiday. So then she made some out of clay to give her grandmother, and I just thought that was so cool and visually just really stunning. If you're interested in full lesson plans and more student examples, check out my website, thatartteacher.com.